Let us start with careers in engineering. There are plenty of careers in engineering. You can go into aviation sector. You can be at the shipping industry. Architecture industry is there. There are various mining, petroleum, plastic, polymer, rubber, mold industry. Tool and dye industry is there. Tool and dye industry is there. Ceramics is there. Textile industry is there. You can go for packaging industry. Leather industry is one important one there. There's also railway and there's also various other technicians opportunities available. Let's take one by one. Let's take aviation. The most important thing in aviation is you got to be someone who knows how to behave, how to talk, to be pleasant enough to do the job. Even in aviation, there are different sectors available. There's a sector for commercial nature. There's also a sector for military sector. So you got to choose which one you are going to go. These are all controlled by an apex body called Directorate General of Civil Aviation in India. This controls it. For someone who is going to work as a pilot, he has to understand that he has to be traveling often, he has to travel long hours, and he has to take care of the safety and security of the passengers he is taking along. So very importantly, a person should have the following personalities. You should have very committed efforts to your job. You should have very good ability and also good health to do the job. You have to act with a strong presence of mind. You should be confident in yourself. If you want to be an air hostess, for example, you have to be polite enough. You need to know how to speak, how to talk, and you have to understand the scenarios and behave accordingly. Someone who is an aircraft engineer, he has to work in different weather conditions, and very importantly, he should work as a team. He cannot say, I will do everything myself, which is impossible. So there are various work options available in aviation sector. Example, you can be an air hostess, you can be a meteorologist, someone who interprets weather data to tell you whether you can fly or not to fly. You can end up in commercial aeroplanes or you can end up in military aeroplanes. You can also be part of the airport services that exist. You can be a pilot, you can be a flight attendant, flight dispatcher, flight scheduler, ground crew. Someone can decide whether what is the time of taking your flight, whether your flight is in order, and you can also look for some marketing business in that. You can also be in the ticketing industry there. You can look for fashion designer can also involve in the aviation sector by designing the clothes of the various crew members. And also you have to look for air flow control. There is ticketing, commercial, there is communication officer. There are also various other officers like aerodrome officers. Someone who talks about airport, someone who talks about aerofitness. So you will have different type of opportunities around in the aviation sector. Again, if you want to go into aviation sector, you got to go into, if you want to go into pilot sector, then you have to study student pilot license. You have to get the student pilot license, which requires you to go for an oral exam. You must be at least of 16 years of age and you should have completed your 10th standard. Then you can go for private pilot licensing, which is including a theory exam plus 60 hours of flying. And there's also commercial pilot license, which is like 250 hours of flying. Normally they expect you to have a plus 2 degree or a higher secondary course completion with maths and physics inside. You can also go for aircraft mechanics. There's a BSc degree in it. Plus you need to have 2 years of practical experience. There are also diploma available in aircraft maintenance engineering. If you want to end up in an air traffic controller, then you got to go into, you have to do engineering degree maybe in electronics, radio communications or telecommunication. There are some reputed institutions in India which also conduct BSc aviation sector, or BTech in the aviation field. Notable of them are MIT in Madras, Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Uran Academy, IGRUA. These are some of those institutions which conduct courses. There are many other institutions as well. Next, let us take shipping industry. In the case of shipping industry, shipping has a lot of things to manage. It requires a huge amount of logistics to be handled. So documentation is highly necessary. People have to understand there are a lot of things coming in, going out. They have to be manipulated or managed properly. There is also things to be related to the routing of the ships themselves. And you have to decide upon loading and unloading of various things from the ship. So these are important things. Working in a dock or a port is not an easy task. You got to spend most of your time. Sometimes it is a noisy environment as well. You can work as a traffic light. You can work as a stewardess or superintendent, somebody who is taking care of loading and unloading stuff. You can have a diploma in shipping management. you can start your job as a deck engineer, then you can get promoted towards the chief engineer. These exams are handled by Directorate General of Shipping in Mumbai. Also, there are reputed institutions. Some of them are Academy of Marine Education and Technology, which is an university. We also have Indian Marine University in Visakhapatnam, which conducts BSc Nautical Sciences or BTech Naval Architecture and Ocean Engineering. There is also BTech Marine Engineering. There is BSc Maritime Sciences. Alappuzha University also conducts MBA in Shipping. Let us take Architecture and Construction Industry. This industry deals with design, plan and building of various structures. We have to think about, you have to dream something. You have to design something nicely, attractive, effective for the civilization to appreciate. You might work most of the time in your office, planning up. Sometimes you need to go to the site to see the environment there. Also, people who want to go into this industry should have very keen intelligence. They should be intelligent enough to think beyond the current field. They should be artistic, creative in their mind. They should also be someone who could plan the structures like. There are various fields available. Landscape architectures are there who help you to plan a city, plan a zone, plan an area. Now it is important to be greenery in nature. So we look for all these things. There are also naval architects who are important, who plan and design ports, dockyard, and also think about how to provide fuel to the ships and other things like. An important personality which is needed for a person to work is to have a tough physique. He should be someone who is strong enough, who has interest in all these kind of structures, who has curiosity to learn, to observe, to look at something and say, okay, this is nice because of these features. He should be good enough in these areas. This selection to this architectural area is done by a NATA exam, National Aptitude Test in Architecture. You should have the ability to be sketching something. You should be able to be creative. You should be able to be planned nicely. BArch is a degree which is for 5 years, and you can end up in landscape architecture, naval architecture, civil engineering, or you can end up in site engineering or surveyors. You can go in different fields. There is also Master of Design conducted by IIT Delhi and other institutions. There is also School of Planning and Architecture in Delhi, which conducts planning for urban region, planning for a regional area, planning about the environment, planning about transport, etc. Let us see about engineering and technology. Engineers are people who apply the theory, who apply things into practice and see whether it can bring us some economical benefits and also some benefits for the people like. There are many engineering professions available. Commonly known are few. They are electronic and telecommunication engineering, who operates on electronic devices, who also look for telecommunication side. These people normally work in the industry. Engineers normally work in the industry. They plan for the market. They have to do some research. They have to understand what is needed by the market, and then they have to plan things like that. On a personality basis, they should have an analytical mind. They should be able to solve problems effectively. They should have very strong mathematical knowledge to pursue something stronger in engineering. There are plenty of courses and plenty of exams available. There is All India Engineering Entrance Exam, there is IITG exam, there is BITS Pilani, which conducts BITSAT. There are many other exams as well. Notable institutions are, some of them we are naming them, there are plenty. We are just naming a very few. National Dairy Research Institute, Kharna, Manipal Institute of Technology, Indian Institute of Fire Engineering at Nagpur, and there are many others, plenty. Electronic and telecommunication engineers can end up in space and defense industry. They can also go for producing commercial electronic communication products. They can also enter into various research organizations. They can end up in R&D, they can end up in teaching, some production, or maybe in servicing. People can do their BE, BTech degree, and they can do their MEM Tech through GATE, Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering. Other than electronics and communication, there is also electronics and computer science, electronics and control, electronics and instrumentation, electronics and telematics, and there are plenty of such branches available. Next, let us see about mining engineers. These are people who look for various mineral deposits around, in and around the earth surface and also in water. They can find out that these can be extracted effectively, economically. That is important. So their plan is to set up mines.